Yesterday's show, we started talking about how, you know, it's getting a little colder out now. You know, fall is right around the corner. And you already know where I'm going, right?
I mean, this guy yesterday.
Unbelievable. I've never experienced anything like this in our history of doing the show here, right? Yesterday, we started the show, and I had a space heater in here. Actually, there is a space heater that sits in the studio right by where I sit.
It's been in here for a long time, right?
Long time. So yeah. I figure, like, all right, maybe somebody else uses it. You know, maybe Tall Kathy uses it after us. Maybe Scottro's using it at night or something. I don't know. It's always been in here, and I'm like, it's always cold in our studio. So I get it. I get why it's there. We never use it, though. Yesterday, I don't know, I was just extremely cold in the studio, so I plugged the space heater in. We're having a good time. Start the show yesterday. I believe I was telling you I got the space heater pointed right at my crotch. We're having fun.
You're turning on me, yeah.
Hot crotches all around. We're having fun. Yeah, you're getting a little blast of the hot air. We're having a good time. We're warming up in the studio. So, you know, I had it going all show and everything. No big deal. We get through the show. And me and Bob are doing some work after the show in the studio. And Bob was down the hall doing something. I was in here by myself. And everything just went pew. Everything shut down. I have four computer screens in front of me. They all went black.
Which are, everything that runs the station here.
The entire control board. I got this big control board in front of me. It all went black. And I was like, oh my God, what happened? And I didn't know what happened at first. And then, you know, once I kind of thought like, oh God, it was the space heater, wasn't it? Like, I blew something up.
It's like, uh-oh.
So we went, we go down the hall, we go get our boy Lou the engineer. He comes in, and we get the station back on the air. The station was off the air for probably like 2 minutes or
right,
so.
Right, right.
I knocked the entire radio station out with my office lady-like tendencies.
Oh, God.
I got to get this space heater going. I knocked the radio station off the air. How is that possible, by the way? How could a space heater take out the station? I did it.
I mean, real office lady move.
So then
you're like the office lady that blows the fuse and like knocks out everybody's power in a row of like cubicles.
I felt so bad. Like our boss David Wood is in here, and Lou the engineer is just like, "Well, was something different? Did something get plugged in?" I'm like, "Yeah, I fessed up to it. I was like, I plugged the space heater in because it's been sitting in here for years. I figured everybody uses it. I don't know. It's what I get, man." That's what I get for going full-blown office lady yesterday, trying to keep myself warm. Oh, gosh.
Ah, jeez.
Get this space heater going on in here. All right. Get this hot air blowing.
Oh, yeah.
I took the station off the air. And then the funny thing was is, you know, Lou the engineer comes in here, fixes everything. And we're thinking, all right, we're back on the air. We're doing good. Me and Bob, we were recording something. We're still doing work in the studio. This is like noon, by the way, at this point. And then all of a sudden, Bob's in here. We both have our headphones on, and then station goes off the air again because apparently the whatever went wrong that was fixed didn't get properly fixed, and it took the station off the air again. We were only off for like a little bit then, but yeah, I'd probably say maybe 3 minutes total yesterday. I disabled the radio station with a space heater. I think we're good now, though. But I had to put the space heater in the other room because I don't even want to see it now.
That's the most office lady thing I think we've ever done.
It is, right? It is. Oh, gosh.
Oh, I took the power out.
Yeah. I disabled an entire radio station with a space heater. That's actually pretty cool, right? That's actually impressive. I'm not even mad at myself for it.
That is kind of impressive.
It is. Like, that's another level of office lady I reached yesterday, though. To disable an entire radio station with a space heater. I'm actually kind of proud of myself, but my apologies to our boss David and Lou the engineer. Apparently, this is not that crazy of a thing, Bob. Purple tweets us here, I freeze at work because if I turn on the space heater, it turns off my computer. Space heaters just destroy offices, I guess. Sonia tweets here, oh dear, Mikey, you are spiraling down towards the office lady blanket path. Whoa. Is that a real thing?
Like a blankie at the desk?
If you can't have a space heater, do office ladies blankie it up? I've never heard of that. That's extreme. Like, I could see if you're wearing extra clothes. Like, I always wear long sleeves in here. It's so cold in our studio as the show goes on. I don't know why. It just does.
Yo, you give me a blankie, I'm gonna be sleeping.
Yeah, I'm gonna nap it up then. No, I don't think I can go that. Brittany tweets here. I've done that a few times with the space heater. My boss sent out a mass email to everybody saying not to use heaters anymore, but I still use mine. I'm a straight up G. Yeah, I can't though. Because I'll take the radio station off the air.
There's nothing we can fix on our own.
Like your computer might go out, and then you're just like, all right, well, I got to call the IT guy to fix this. That's not a big deal. It's a big deal if I knock the radio station off the air with a space heater.
I think the only way we can survive is skin on skin.
Probably body heat. We're going to have to embrace one another. Nude? Underwear on.
Underwear on.
Underwear on.